Hello students, Standard 8. We are going to start chapter 2 today. Linear equations in one variable. Now, in the previous standards, you already learn about the algebraic expressions in which we know the combination of variables and constants. You are familiar with the variable and constants, but I am going to repeat it. Variable means that the number or the symbol whose value is not fixed, value can vary, it can take different values, then it is known as variable. And to denote the variable, we take x, y, z, etc. While constant means whose value is fixed, fixed value. Here, not fixed value. So when it is value is not fixed, it is variable, value is fixed, then it is constant. Like 5, 7, minus 15, 100, etc. Sometimes when we need, we take A, B, C to denote that it is constant. But they will also have the definite value. Not like their value will be changed. But sometimes we have to use, that you will learn in the other standards also. But now you have to only remember that algebraic expressions are the combination of the variable and constants. So what is algebraic expression actually? They are the combination. Algebraic expression is the combination of variables and constants. Using any plus, minus, multiply or divide. Using any 1, 2, 3 or 4 operations, when they are combined together, they becomes algebraic expression. For example, 3x, 5x minus 9, then 3x plus y, 8x square plus 7x, y, etc. Here you will see that it is multiplication, and subtraction. Here it is 3xy multiplication, here plus. So here you will see that these all are known as expressions. So, and x and y are also used. So they are known as algebraic expressions because they are used in the algebra. Now, what is the linear expressions? Now from algebraic expression, we have to learn about the linear expressions. Because here, we have linear equations. So before we go to the equation, what is a linear variable? Linear equation means, linear expression. It means that the highest power, the highest power of variable is 1. Means the degree of the expression is 1. Means like 3x plus 5y. Here you can see that power is 1, y power also is 1. So this is called a linear expression. 3xy plus 9x plus 5y. Here also you here, but you will see that there is x and y together, and 1 power will make 2 power. So this is not a linear expression. In linear expression, yes, if you take out this one, that is linear expression. Or 3x plus 7, 9y minus 8. These all are linear expressions. Now, this is also linear expression, this is linear expression. But what is difference in it? Here, there are two variables are used. But we need here linear equations in one variable. So first, linear expression with one variable. So this is linear expression, but it is with two variables, x and y. But here, in both this, in that one and this one, the only one here x, only one y is here. So they are known as linear expressions in one variable. Now, what is equation? So equation, that is the important thing now, that what is the linear equation. First, what is equation? An equation is a statement having sign of equality means is equal to, with unknown quantity. So equation is a statement having sign of equality and which contains unknown quantity. Now it means that there is a sign of equality in between somewhere. So in the both side there can be expressions or there can be numbers. So the expression which is on the left side of the equality sign is known as LHS, means left hand side, and the expression which is on the right side of the equality sign is known as RHS, or the right hand side. An equality sign shows that the value on the LHS and value on the RHS is always equal. Values and of LHS and values of RHS will be always equal. And when we find the value of the unknown, okay, let me take examples of the linear equation in one variable. Suppose we are given that 2x plus 5 is equal to 7. Here you can see that there is an equality sign here. Therefore, this is a linear equation and only one variable we have used, x. So this is the example of linear equation in one variable. Here LHS, what is LHS? Means what is the sign? 2x plus, that is the LHS, and RHS is 7. So the expression on the left side is only 2x plus 5. So 2x plus 5 is known as left hand side LHS. And on the right side, only 7 there. So RHS is equal to 7. So it is not necessary that every time in the RHS there will be only constant. The variables can come on the both side. Variable can exist on the both side also. For example, we can say that 3x plus 7 is equal to 9x minus 8. This is also a linear equation in one variable. Doesn't matter, x is used at two places, but at least one variable only. But if you take like that, 3x plus 2y is equal to 7. It is also a linear equation, but it is linear equation with two variables. And that, about that you have to learn in the next standard 9th. But now you have to learn about only the linear equation in one variable, and then to find the solution or the root of the equation. So now I hope everybody is familiar with the linear equation in one variable. So the equality sign shows that the equation must be balanced, means the value on the LHS and value on the RHS must be equal. So now, what is the solution of the equation? Now there come the solution of equation. Now we know that in the equation there is a variable always used, otherwise it is not a linear equation in one variable. So like here you can take 5x plus 4 is equal to 9. I have this equation. Now I have to find the value of the variable x such that the value on the LHS and RHS will be equal. If I take x is equal to 1, suppose, then 5 ones are 5 plus 4, 9. Oh, I got the solution at the first attempt. In the standard 6 also we learn about it. And standard 7 also you learn about it. And in that there was a method, trial and error method. Trial and error method we were taking like that. Suppose we can take another example to understand the trial and error method. But we are not going to use that trial and error method, because sometimes that trial and error method goes long. Because maybe their answer is like x is equal to 10. Then you have to check for 1, check for 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. And that is a long process. So we are not going to learn, but I am just going to explain you. Suppose that x plus 4 is equal to 9. Now if I take 1, then LHS will be 1 plus 4 is equal to 5. RHS is 9. So they are not equal. If I take x is equal to 2, 2 plus 4 is 6 only. RHS is not equal. But if I put x is equal to 5, then 5 plus 4 is equal to 9. RHS is also 9. So here, the solution of equation is x is equal to 5. Because when you put the value of x as 5, only that time the values on the both sides will be equal. Here 5 plus 4 is 9, here also 9. So equation will have only a unique solution, or it is also known as the root. Sometimes to confuse you, they can put the different words also. You find the solution. Find the solution of the equation. Or solve the equation. Or find root of the equation. Question can be asked any of the three types. But you have to do what? We have to find the value of the unknown number used in it. Sometimes it will be x, sometimes y, sometimes p, q, t, anything can be used. So whatever variable is used, we have to find the value of that variable to get the solution of the equation. And I hope you remember what I explained in the last standard also. So when we find the value of the unknown number, we have to take some numbers or some terms from left side to RHS, LHS to RHS, and sometimes you have to bring from RHS to LHS. And I hope everybody is remembering with that reverse story I already explained you in previous standards, that when we cross the river, we have to change the clothes. But don't write down that in exams. That if plus sign is that side, when it goes that side, it becomes minus. Minus becomes plus. Multiply becomes divide. And divide becomes multiply. Similarly, if it is in the numerator, then it goes to the denominator. And if it is in the denominator, it goes to the numerator. And it is true for both sides. If you go from LHS to RHS or from RHS to LHS, and that is known as transposing. Means when you take the values or the terms from LHS to RHS, means we transfer it. So the process of carrying terms from one side to another is called transposing. What is transposing means? That when you take the terms from one side to another side. For example, look here, 5x plus 7 is equal to say 8. So now first I will keep 5x and I have to take 7 this side. Means I am transposing 7 to RHS means 8 minus 7. So we get 5x is equal to 8 minus 7 is 1. And now transposing 5 to that side means it will go 1 upon 5. So that is the solution of the equation. So here, what is the transposing? Transposing means shifting or transferring, taking the terms from one side to another side. So the process of carrying terms from one side to another is called transposing. And we can transpose a term from one side of an equation to the other side by merely changing its sign. So if you take the whole term here, then you have to change the sign either from plus to minus or from minus to plus. So now we are going to do some examples that is in the book. The first type, there are different type of equations will come in this chapter. First type is the solution in which linear equation in which linear expression is on one side and new numbers on the other side. That is the simplest form. Linear equations in which linear expression is on one side and numbers on the other side. Means the variable will not be on the both sides. That is the simplest form of the equation. For example, we can take like here, solve 2y plus 9 equals 4. So first of all, 9 you will take that side. So transposing 9 to RHS. So what will you get? 2y is equal to 4 minus 9, because plus 9 becomes minus this side. So 2y is equal to 4 minus 9. Now 4 minus 9 will be minus 5. So y is equal to, now we have to take 2 from left side to RHS. So it is in the numerator, so it will go in the denominator. So minus 5 upon 2. Therefore, that is the solution of the equation. 2y plus 9 is equal to 4. And according to that, we can take a different type of sums. Now we are going to do some examples from the exercise, so you can understand, and then the other sum you can do yourself in your book. So whatever is important thing in this chapter I explained, you can make a note and write down in it, and then the sums of the exercise which are left, you can do it by yourself. Question number 1, exercise 2.1. Solve the following equations. First question is x minus 2 equals 7. Now it is not necessary to write down that thing I told you, transposing. Only you have to remember that when you take one term from LHS to RHS or from RHS to LHS, it is known as transposing. But you don't have to write down every time. So here, what do we do first? Okay. And one thing to remember, whenever you solving the equation, don't write down equal to 2 times here. Because generally, you have the habit of writing down equal to here. But in the equation, we have to write down therefore sign, mean the 3 dots in a triangle. Like that, therefore. Because 2 times, it cannot be equality sign. So now x minus 2 is equal to 7. So here, x will remain in this side. So x is equal to 7 is at this, but minus 2 is going that side, transposing, so it will become plus. So therefore, x is equal to 9. And then that is your answer. Very simple. These are the simplest questions. Let's take another one, like fourth one. 3 by 7 plus x is equal to 17 upon 7. So here we have to transpose 3 by 7. That's it. But you are taking whole term. Therefore it will not be inverted. But it will be only, if it is plus, it will become minus. Therefore, x is equal to 17 upon 7. This 3 by 7 whole thing going that side will become minus. So it will be minus 3 upon 7. Therefore, x is equal to, what is 17? Now here, both the denominators are equal. So you put 7 here and 17 minus 3. So what is the 17 minus 3? It is 14. 14 divided by 7. So here you can use it. You can simplify 7 to the 14. Therefore, x is equal to 2. Very, very simple equation. Let's take another sum. Let's take a little difficult one. Actually, not difficult. Okay, take the point one. 8th one. 1.6 is equal to y upon 1.5. Here you can see that variable is on the right side. Doesn't matter. It is only one side. So what can we do? We can bring 1.5 that side. Right? We can bring 1.5 that side. So 1.6 multiply, because it is in the numerator denominator. So when it comes in this side, it will come in the numerator. So it will be in the multiplication. 1.6 multiplied by 1.5 is equal to 1. So you can write down the vice versa also. So y is equal to, therefore, y is equal to, now we have to multiply 16 by 15. 1.6 multiplied by 1.5. So without point, you can multiply first. Now there is one decimal place here, one decimal place here. So in the answer there will be 2. So it will be 2.40. But last 0 you can cancel out. Therefore y is equal to 2.4. That is the answer of this sum. So it is very, very simple. Let's take another one example. Okay, 14y minus 8 equals 13. So now here, 14y we will keep as it is first, because y is containing. So we will take minus 8 that side, it will become plus. So 14y, question number 10 here, 14y is equal to 13, minus 8 becomes plus 8. Therefore, 14y is equal to 13 plus 8, how much? 21. And therefore, y is equal to, now 14 is going that side. It will not become minus, but it will go in the denominator, 14. Now you can simplify 3 sevens are and 2 sevens are. So y is equal to 3 upon 2. So that is the method. Very, very simple. But don't forget to change the sign. Sometimes they are transposing from here to that side, but keeping the same sign. If you keep same sign here, minus 8, then it will become wrong answer. So don't forget to change the sign when you transpose the whole term from one side to another side. Thank you very much. If there is any question, you can write down in the comment section, and the other one we will take in the next video. Thank you very much.